I don't expect Amen. A gift on your birthday. Amen.
All right.
But again, the devil has a way of taking something that is so special, so significant, and taking away from what it really is.
Amen.
Praise God, somebody. And what he does is he tries to say, well, when you say stuff like what I just said, you just boiling everything. You just taking the fun out of it. If the fun is so good, y'all ain't saying that. Until you have forgot what the real occasion is, maybe some of the fun ought to be taken out. Maybe we all just realize what it's all about. Praise God. He said, joy to the world. The Lord is come. Let us receive her King. Praise God. Joy to the world. Not depression. Not sadness. Not sorrow. But joy to the world. Because the Lord is God. And the good thing about it, he didn't keep coming and going. The fact that he has come. He says, I am the light of the world. And as long as I'm in the world, I am the light thereof.
Amen.
But the devil
likes
to start off saying, well, this is the first Thanksgiving since mama died.
All right.
Since daddy died.
Yeah.
Grandmama died. Now, I don't want to downplay death. But I want you to know it's going to happen to all of us.
Amen.
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 Amen. And if folk will use it properly, it is not to make it look like it's not a God.
Amen.
But it reminds us that it really is a God.
Amen.
So God ordered and ordained death. Amen. God ordered and ordained life. And nobody else, nobody has power over life and death but God. Amen. In other words, I don't care how mad somebody get with you, they can't make you die. Amen. Don't care what they shoot you with, they can. God got the last one to die.
Amen.
For you to die. Y'all ain't saying it doesn't matter how bad somebody wants you to live. But depression sets in. And let me show you something. If whoever you are sad and depressed over, if there's something good about them, they made an impact in your life. If you were impressed with them, if you had an appreciation for them, if they lived a life worth emulating, the best thing that you can do is live the life, continue to be, strive to be what they were or more. You understand? Rather than say, oh, I can't do this.
My Lord.
It's not God's will.
Amen.
That we be depressed.
Amen.
Or that our heads be hung in sorrow.
Amen.
For after all, he's a good God.
Amen.
And every life that we mourn, it belonged to God.
Yeah.
Every person that we miss,
thank you, God.
They belong to God.
Yeah.
You and I belong to God. And God's will, his desire is that we worship him in spite of.
Amen.
God loves us in spite of what we have done. And we ought to love and worship God in spite of what our conditions are. No matter what you have gone through, you ought to be thankful to God that you are alive. All God bad it has got. If you've got breath in your body, there's hope. Amen. If God woke you up again another day, there's still hope for a better day. I don't believe better days come from rejecting God. I don't believe better days come from walking away from God. But I believe better days come, as the scripture says, by seeking God. going to have to first believe that he exists. And that he's a rewarder of them that would diligently seek after him. That is to say, what I'm looking for, I got to find. I can't leave your house if I can't find my keys. So I'm not just but I'm moving stuff. I'm flipping stuff over. I'm clearing stuff out the way, looking for my keys. And if you're going to diligently seek God, you got to put stuff and people out of your way. And you got to seek him. You got to acknowledge that you cannot live without him. I can't make it another day. I can't even walk without your help. You got to seek God. Psalmist David writes here. The Bible says it's also recorded in 1 Chronicles, the 16th chapter, verses 7 through 22. When David had again retrieved the Ark of the Covenant, which to Israel would have appeared to be something similar to a good luck charm. You understand, when the ark was in place, then God blessed them. And they had great success. They had victories in war. God blessed them abundantly. And this is what I say, when you be where you're supposed to be, you get what you're supposed to have. When you acknowledge God as God, when you accept God for who he is, accept God's will, amen, then God can bless you as well. But they had again recovered the Ark of the Covenant. And they were very joyous. David writes this psalm saying, give thanks unto the Lord. We are a people.